Hey folks, it's Matt Rainwater here, and you may have noticed my hair is gone, my beard is gone. I tried to do my own hair, tried to get myself a haircut, and I've done it in the past fairly successfully, but this last time I didn't. So I made a mistake where it was like, there's only one way to fix this. The only way is through, and so I ended up having to cut my hair pretty short. Today, I had polled y'all on the Patreon about, I wanted to do some digital painting. And last night I spent a lot of time practicing, kind of doing some Bob Ross type paintings, just, you know, mountains and trees and easy stuff like that. And the point of it is that ultimately I want to take all these skills and use them for a promotional banner I'm going to be using for Trailer Park Warlock in season 3. So that's still, you know, it's a couple months from now, so I'm going to train in preparation for that. And so I'm just using this time to get used to all the digital brushes that I have at my disposal. And there's a lot of them. And that's actually, for me, the most challenging part of all this is that I have probably 200 different brushes. I don't really know how to use all of them. And I'm just going to switch over here. Let's see how we can do this, because I just realized I kind of messed up. So yeah, I have all these brushes. I have to figure out how to use them all, because I don't know how to use them all. And maybe some of them don't all have, you know, a utility that I'm going to necessarily find a use for. So that's the challenge, right? So today, today I'm just going to do something I'm already fairly used to, and I'm going to do some character painting, so like just like a quick portrait, and we'll try. I'm having to draw in a way I prefer not to, because I've discovered if I try and switch over to tablet mode on my laptop, it'll just shut off OBS, and I'm already committed to this one. All right. This will probably be more difficult than I'd like it to be, but that's okay. So yeah, I'm just going to do like kind of a quick little painting of Angelic Pointu. I'm just calling him that. In my mind, he isn't really an angel. He's just kind of a transformed daywalker being. But it's an easy way to refer to him. Refer to this version of him. Because he has, you know, there's his lowest will, which is demonic. And then I would call this his highest will. Even the lower higher thing is kind of a just names I'm throwing on. All right. Let's do a bust. Okay. All right. I am going to try a couple of different things in this painting. So I'm going to create a new layer. And then I'm going to, all right, go into my brushes and I'm going to go with oil. Let's try it out. Let's try some new things. That's the whole point, right? All right. Except, yeah, I don't like the lack of. What's up with that? It's not really like lined in, like a. Okay. All right, let's try something else. So I'm just gonna start flatting in this color shape. We'll do it like that. This actually, this is the other thing I wanna do. I'm gonna take this color, fill it. Excuse me. All right. And we're going to go back. Right now, I'm just kind of getting the basic, you know, the basic stuff figured out. Contours, so to speak. All right, I'm gonna go underneath that layer and I'm gonna fill in and flat. Flat this part. I might have to decrease the opacity of this layer so I can see the line art for a little bit. But so long as I know that that's there. Oops. There we go. All right. Clavicle. All right. Think that looks all right. So, halo. Let's do that. Like that. All right, that's the basic part of it. There's gonna be a lot of layers. I think. All right. And then I'm gonna go in. I'm gonna erase a little bit of this layer with his blue flame hair, just to better define his ear. Okay. Cool. And now I'm going to go in and start having some fun. or try to. Let's see. I'm going to go with the old standby. This is my favorite brush in my toolbox, so to speak. And it is the gouache brush. I just really like the line art, not the lines, the texture it makes. Let's see. That's a little too. I need something more like that. So now I can just start having some fun making all these weird flame patterns. Oh, yeah, I could just do that. so much of painting seems about thinking about brushstroke, thinking about how I'm trying to figure out how to explain what I'm trying to say. Like the path of your brushstroke. It's the best way I can put it. Let's try this. Or this is the way that I'm thinking about digital painting anyway. Excuse me. We'll start there. There's plenty that I can do after. I think the next thing I'm gonna do is mess around with this halo. Once again, gonna use the old gouache. That's better. I think I mentioned this last video, but growing up, a lot of my art learning was in painting. And so I'm finding myself sort of in this place of going backwards and learning a bit, like, you know, solidifying those skills, basically. And, I mean, doing it in an unusual way, in a sense, because I'm solidifying those skills digital painting, which is, it's a very different beast. It really is. Largest because you just can't, you can't fill the paint. You can't fill the brush in your hand. There is a lot of, I don't know, there's a lot that comes with learning that learning your painting techniques by being able to kind of feel what's in your hand, right? If you don't have that, it does make it a little bit more difficult, at least in my opinion. But it's a trade-off, because then you also get to set up your own layers. That doesn't look good. Set up your own layers, which is pretty nice. It's pretty convenient. You get to fix your mistakes. You have more flexibility in fixing your mistakes rather than just having to like start over or wait for the paint to dry, that kind of thing. All right. That's looking okay. It's going to have to be I'm going to have to do a lot of fixing up. So next thing I'm gonna merge some layers. Merge. I'm gonna merge that layer. Curious what would happen. Yeah, okay. All right. So here comes the tricky part, because I haven't really thought this through at all. Let's see. I want a detail brush of some sort. Let's try Lush Larry. It's the name of the brush. It's Lush Larry. Don't know why, but that's what it's called. All right. Let's try it. Maybe I could do that differently. All right. I'm thinking, gonna rethink that approach. Nope. What I want, I'm trying to figure out how to imply some value here. About this. Oh. Tricky. It's just tricky. All right, maybe that's what I'll do. Change the density. Okay, that's what I need to do. Need to change the density. So I just want to kind of make a little bit of... come on. All right. Just trying to imply some of Pointu's form with this brush. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, it looks all right. I'll do that. Don't really want to... I'm trying to avoid using like a hard edge line for this painting. I might end up having to. Oops. I think next time though, of course, next time I might be doing like a landscape painting for that banner I was talking with you all about, but I think next time I'll make sure I have something a little bit more prepared. Yeah, I'm just gonna totally redo that line. All right, nose. I think, I didn't think about it that way. I could have outlined it instead with reflective colors. And this is the other part about, like, so for me right now, painting is kind of feeling like puzzle solving, because you have to really think through a lot of your, where you're placing your lines, where you're placing color, blah, blah, blah. It's challenging. It's just thinking, you know, thinking through it in a new way. All right. There we go. Just trying to find the oil brush. Knew something was missing. I don't know. It's shaping up, I guess. That's the thing. I have to really get used to the idea that when I'm doing painting, there's just gonna be like a phase of it that I'm not gonna like. An ugly phase, so to speak. That. Kind of make it look a little bit more, make his hair look more fire-like. It's pretty, seems like a cool effect. I don't know. Oops, I have to make that smaller. I hate working on a laptop like this, but like I said, I'm already committed to it. Because if I try and change it, it'll just shut off OBS. So, well. Oh well. I have to remember that next time. All right, so something else I'm noticing. I think these flames are a little too, the inner flame is a little too intense of a white or something. Like it's too much or something. So I'm going to try and blend it a little bit more. Except, nope, I don't like that color. Don't like it at all. No, sir, I don't like it. Let's do that. Matches up a little too well with his ear. There we go. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. All right. All right. I'm gonna work on the inner flame on his goatee. And just a little bit of make another layer. Just kind of go in, revise. I guess that's the other thing about painting that's kind of like challenging is a lot of it is about revision. It's almost like Sounds like writing. I mean, I don't revise as much when I'm drawing because I have it so... I have it set in such a... what's the word? I have it down to a science, basically. And so I'm not having to think it through as much. The only problem with that is you can get kind of set in your ways. So I'm trying to break through that a little bit right now. Right? Like, that's part of improving as an artist is to find what are your set thought patterns and then break those thought patterns so you can go in new directions. Create new possibilities. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. Oil. I'm gonna make this, I want this to bigger than that. So after I'm done with this painting, y'all, I'm gonna be going to do some dialogue writing for Trailer Park Warlock episode. What is it? Episode 62. We're getting really close to the end, y'all. Really close. Say 58. Yeah, Thursday 58 was released, right? And we're gonna end the season on 65. So for y'all, 7 more episodes. For me, I have 3 more episodes to make, and then I'll be all done for this season. Season 3 is gonna be a little bit different in the sense that it's gonna be a bit more like, it's gonna be a bit more like season 1, a little more episodic. There's gonna be some through lines of story arcs. But for season 3, I just want to kind of focus a little bit more on doing some gags. And also just focusing more on Jake. This season, really, Jake didn't get a lot of... Poor guy didn't get a lot of attention. And so I think that's something, I don't know, something me and my editor talked about, something that's been on my mind for a while, and I want to make sure season 3 is very specifically focusing on Jake as much as I can. And some stuff with Darla I might want to touch. There is some stuff with Bev. I have a really funny idea for a small story arc that involves Bev that I hope y'all enjoy when it happens. It's gonna be like a year from now, probably. But, I have a pretty hilarious idea. We'll get there. Cool. That's exactly what I was trying to go for. Now, okay, I might have to go back and fix that. I don't like the way that looks. Okay. Yeah, I figured this would be a fun painting to do because I could try out some interesting combinations of colors. All right. Yeah. Cool. Nose is itchy again. Why is my nose always itchy every time I do a video? Like a it's like a nervous thing. What's up with that? Alright, there's some cleanup I'm gonna have to do. It's gonna be the last phase, basically. Because it's coming together, but it's not quite. It's looking a little shabby. Alright, how are we gonna do this? I want a thinner line, more paint. excuse me, sorry. Yeah, okay. Because now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and refine these contours. And, like so. Guess that's the only problem about doing this character, because this version of Pointu doesn't really. He doesn't have typical shading and lighting characteristics, so next time I'm going to do something a little more straightforward. So what I'm doing here is just going in with an eraser just to lighten some of this. Take that. Come on. What would I do beyond this point? think, yeah, this is going to be very, this is going to be very different. I don't want to do that. I want to do, okay. Hurt my brain. I don't know why. Making new neural connections, I guess that's why. Okay, next thing I'm going to do. I'm gonna crop. Okay. All right. And I'm gonna go in and just mess around with the background a little bit. I don't feel like this is a finished, this is gonna be a finished painting. Unfortunately. Hard to imagine it feeling like a finished painting, at least looking at it right now, but let's see how I feel, let's see where we're at. So mess around with the background a little bit. It's bogging down my computer's processor speed. I hate that. Oops. What happened? All right, now I'm gonna just get the soft brush, the airbrush, go in here. Oops. No. It's better going darker. Got more cleanup to do, I'm seeing. Oh, you know what? I got his darn wings. It's not the first time I've done that either. There's been a couple of times I've been drawing and I forget to, like, I knew something was missing. just didn't know what. Make another layer. Also, that just doesn't make sense. Maybe it does. I don't know. Having a hard time. Having a hard time with this one. All right. This still feels very unfinished, but I might have to just, 'cause I still have, yeah, I still have a lot of work I have to do today. But I'm gonna try and finish this out as best as I can, y'all, before I sign off. I think the only other thing I could imagine myself doing that would help is put in some shadows. That shadow I have on his ear is just a little much. I don't know. It might be too late. Oh, no. I can fix it. Okay. Great. It's okay. It's all right. It's not, not quite where I'd like it to be. I might mess around with it a little bit more later on tonight, but I gotta cap it out for right now. I'm just gonna mess with this halo. that's nice. That helps. Still want to mess around with this inner flame. So I'll do that. I need to be done. What happened? I almost just want to get rid of it completely because I don't know. I feel like it's detracting in some way. Having a hard time with it, y'all. I don't know. Something about it. Just not. It's not doing it for me. Doesn't work like I wanted it to. Let's try that. I know, I keep saying I need to stop, and I'm like wanting to do more. Oh no. Having a hard time with it. Well, I'm going to say this experiment is done for right now. Come back to it later. Thanks, y'all, for hanging out. And hope y'all have enjoyed this time. And I'll be doing more paintings in the future. And hope y'all having a good one. Staying safe out there. Staying healthy, staying well. And I will talk to y'all later, all right?